Dear students, today we are going to explain the next system from the same topic, that is the phase equilibrium, sulfur system. Sulfur system is called as a one component four phase system. How it is one component and four phase system, that we have to see. Sulfur system is called as a one component system and a four phase system. The four phases are rhombic sulfur, that is SR, monoclinic sulfur, that is SM, sulfur liquid, that is SL, and sulfur vapor, that is SV. These are the four phases which are present in the sulfur system, and hence it is called a four phase system. All the four phases having a only one chemical entity, that is sulfur. Rhombic sulfur is chemically sulfur, monoclinic sulfur is chemically sulfur, sulfur liquid and sulfur vapor is also chemically sulfur. Means only one chemical entity, that is sulfur, is sufficient to explain the composition of all the four phases, and hence the system is called as a one component system, and hence it is called as a one component and four phase system. The two crystalline forms, that is the sulfur SR form and SM form, that is sulfur rhombic and sulfur monoclinic, they are showing the transition at 95.6 degrees Celsius. SR starts to convert into SM at 95.6 degrees Celsius, and showing the reversible conversion as SM to SR also at the same temperature, and hence 95.6, this temperature is called a transition point of that two enantiomers, that is SR and SM. This sulfur system we have to see in detail with the help of phase diagram. This is the phase diagram of the sulfur system, or the PT diagram. Why it is called a PT diagram? Because pressure and temperature is showing the effect on the different phases. Hence it is called a PT diagram also, or the phase diagram. This phase diagram is divided into the four regions: solid rhombic, solid monoclinic, liquid sulfur and sulfur vapor. These are the four regions of the phase diagram. The salient features of the phase diagram or the sulfur system are as: there are six curves, curve AB, curve BC, curve CD, curve BE, curve CE and curve EG. There are three triple points, point B, point C and point E. The four areas are ABG marked as solid rhombic, BEC marked as solid monoclinic, GECD marked as liquid sulfur, and ABCD marked as sulfur vapor. These are the salient features of the phase diagram. Six curves AB, BC and CD. Then BE, CE and another curve EG. These are the six curves. Then triple points, triple point B, triple point C and triple point E. Then the areas A, B, E, G marked as solid rhombic. Then B, E, C, this is the area which is marked as solid monoclinic. Then G, E, C, D, this area is represented by the sulfur liquid and area A, B, C, D is marked as sulfur vapor. These are the four areas which are present on the phase diagram. Now we have to see the salient features one by one. First of all, we will see the curves. First of all, we will see regarding the curve AB. Curve AB is a curve. Along this curve, vapor pressure curve of SR is its name. It shows the vapor pressure of solid rhombic sulfur at different temperatures. Along this curve, two phases SR and SV are in equilibrium, and hence the degree of freedom F is equal to C minus P plus 2. By solving it, we will get the one, that is the system SR oblique SV has one degree of freedom, and hence it is a monovalent system. Along the curve AB, this one, SR and SV are in equilibrium along the curve AB, and degree of freedom is 1. Hence the system along the curve AB is monovalent. Then curve BC is a curve. Along this curve BC, this curve BC is named as vapor pressure curve of solid monoclinic sulfur. Along this curve, two phases are in equilibrium, that is solid monoclinic from this side and sulfur vapor from this side. Means SM and SV are in equilibrium along the curve BC. The degree of freedom is also 1. How it is calculated, we will see on the PPT. Along this curve BC, there are two phases, that is SM and SV are in equilibrium. Means phases are 2, and hence the value of P is 2. Component is 1. Being the SM and SV are explained with the help of one chemical entity, that is sulfur. Hence the component is 1. 1 minus 2 plus 2. By solving it, we will get the value 1. That is degree of freedom is equal to 1. And hence the along the curve BC, the system is monovalent. Then we have to see the next curve. That is curve CD. This is curve CD. We have to see regarding this curve CD. Along this curve CD, there are two phases which are in equilibrium, that is liquid sulfur and sulfur vapor are in equilibrium along the curve CD. Along the curve CD, that curve shows the vapor pressure of liquid sulfur at different temperatures. The degree of freedom F is equal to C minus P plus 2 is equal to 1 minus 2 plus 2 is equal to 1. Means the system along the curve CD having degree of freedom 1, and hence the system is monovalent. One atmosphere line meets this curve at 444.6 degrees Celsius, that is the boiling point of sulfur. Then the next curve we have to see, that is the BE. We have to see, we have seen just curve CD. Then we have to see the curve BE, this one. This curve we have to see, curve BE. Curve B is named as transition curve of the solid rhombic sulfur. It shows the effect of pressure on the transition temperature for SR and SM. Along this curve, Two phases are in equilibrium, that are SR and SM are in equilibrium, and hence the degree of freedom by putting the value of C and P is 1, and hence the system is monovariant. System SR oblique SM has 1 degree of freedom, and hence it is a monovariant system. The transformation of SR and SM is accompanied by increase of volume and absorption of heat. Thus, the increase of pressure will shift the equilibrium curve to the right, and the transition temperature will also raise. This curve BE is a transition curve of the solid rhombic. Why it is called a transition curve? Because in this case there is a transition from SR to SM. Along this curve, SR and SM are in equilibrium, but this curve is showing the slope. It slopes away from the pressure axis. As pressure increases, the transition temperature goes on increasing. Along this curve, the degree of freedom is 1, and hence the system is monovariant. Being the component is 1, phases are 2, by putting the values of C and P in the phase rule, F is equal to C minus P plus 2, we will get the 1, and hence the system along the curve BE is monovariant. Then curve CE, this one. This curve CE shows the equilibrium between solid monoclinic and liquid sulfur. This curve is called the fusion curve of solid monoclinic. In this case, this curve is also showing that as the temperature pressure increases, the temperature of fusion temperature is also increasing. Along this curve, two phases are in equilibrium, that is the SM and SL. And hence the degree of freedom is also 1, that we have to see on PPT. Curve CE. Along the curve CE, degree of freedom, component is 1, phases are 2, and hence after calculating we will get the degree of freedom 1. Hence the system is monovariant along the curve CE. Then we have to see the next curve, that is the EG. Along the curve CE, SM and SL are in equilibrium, and this curve ends at E because SM ceases to exist beyond this point. And along this curve, two phases are in equilibrium, SM and SL. And in this case, increase of pressure shift the equilibrium curve towards the right. The melting point we also raised. Then the next curve, EG, we have to see. The curve EG, that is called the fusion curve of SR. It shows the effect of pressure on melting point of SR. Along this curve, two phases SR and SL are in equilibrium. Degree of freedom F is equal to C minus P plus 2 is equal to 1 minus 2 plus 2 is equal to 1. The system SR oblique SL has 1 degree of freedom, and hence it is monovariant. The curve EG. Curve EG is this one. Along this curve, SR from left side and SL from right side are in equilibrium along the curve EG. And degree of freedom along this curve is 1. And hence the system along the curve EG is called monovariant. In this way, we have seen the six curves, curve AB, curve BC, curve CD, then curve BE, curve CE, and EG.
Now I am explaining sulfur system in detail for the further understanding. Sulfur system is called as a one component and four phase system. Why it is called one component system and why it is called four phase system, that we have to see. In the sulfur system there are four phases which we are taking under consideration on the phase diagram. That four phases are solid rhombic, solid sulfur rhombic, solid sulfur monoclinic. These are the two solid phases. Then sulfur liquid and sulfur vapor. These are the four phases which are present in the sulfur system. Solid rhombic, solid monoclinic sulfur, sulfur liquid and sulfur vapor. These are the four phases which are shown on the phase diagram. And hence sulfur system is called as a four phase system. Sulfur rhombic, sulfur monoclinic, sulfur liquid and sulfur vapor. These are the four phases. And why it is called a one component, that we have to see. All the four phases having chemical constituent sulfur only, means with the help of only one chemical constituent, that is sulfur, all the four phases can be chemically explained. Or the composition of all the four phases is explained with the help of one chemical entity, and hence it is a one component system. Sulfur system is a one component and a four phase system, and this system is explained with the help of this phase diagram or the PT diagram. This diagram is also called a PT diagram. P stands for pressure and T stands for the temperature. These salient features of the phase diagram or the system, sulfur system, as the curves. There are six curves: AB, BC, CD, BE, CE and EG. These are the six curves which are shown on the phase diagram. Which are that? AB, BC, CD, BE, CE and EG. This one. These are the six curves which are present in the phase diagram. Then the tipple points. There are three tipple points: tipple point B, tipple point C and tipple point E. Means there are three tipple points in the sulfur system that are B, C, E. B, C, E. Areas. There are four areas: A, B, E, G. A, B, E, G. Marked as solid rhombic sulfur. Then B, E C. This one, this is marked as solid monoclinic sulfur B E C. Then G E C D. G E C D. This area is represented by the sulfur liquid. Then area A B C D is represented by the sulfur vapor. A B C D. These are the four areas. Means this phase diagram is divided into the four regions. This one, 1, 2, 3, and 4. With the help of six curves. That six curves are A, B, B, C, C, D, B, E, C, E, and E, G. These are the six curves. That six curves divide the phase diagram into four regions or areas. And in this phase diagram, there are three triple points. Triple point B, triple point C, triple point E. Then we have to start to explain one by one. Initially, we start the explanation regarding the curves. Curve AB. Initially, I am explaining curve AB. Curve AB. This curve AB is called as vapor pressure curve of SR. During the explanation of all these curves, we have to keep in mind these things. First of all, write down the name of the curve or explain regarding the name of the curve. Then equilibrium, between which phases there is equilibrium. Then degree of freedom, F is equal to how much, and any special point regarding that curve, that we have to explain with the help of these four points. Name of the curve AB is the vapor pressure curve of SR. Then the second point is that equilibrium. Which two phases are in equilibrium along the curve AB, that we have to see. From the upper side on the phase diagram, solid rhombic, that is SR, present. From lower side on the phase diagram, sulfur vapor, that is SL, is existed. Means along the curve AB, there are two phases which are coexisted. And showing the equilibrium between the SR and SL. Means SR and SL is showing equilibrium between along the curve AB. SR and SV is showing the equilibrium along the curve AB. Then degree of freedom along the curve AB, that we have to calculate. As per the phase rule equation, F is equal to C minus P plus 2. How many components are present along the curve AB? Along the curve AB, there are two phases, SR and SV. SR having the chemical component are composition sulfur, and SV is also having a chemical composition sulfur. Means the component is one, chemical composition is one, and hence C, value of C is one. Minus P stands for phases. Number of phases along the curve AB are 2, SR and SV. SR solid rhombic, sulfur rhombic, and SV stands for sulfur paper. Means two phases are in equilibrium along the curve AB. Hence 2 plus 2 plus 2 minus 2 will be cancelled and it will come 1. Means F is equal to 1. Hence the system is monovariant. Along the curve AB, the system is monovariant, being the degree of freedom is 1. Then we have to see the next curve, that is curve BC. Name of the curve BC, vapor pressure curve of SM. Vapor pressure curve of SM means along the curve BC, a effect of pressure at different temperatures are going to be studied. Along the curve BC, which phases are in equilibrium from upper side on the phase diagram SM, that is solid monoclinic or sulfur monoclinic is present, and from the lower side on the phase diagram sulfur vapor is coexisted. Means along the curve BC, two phases are in equilibrium, that is SM and SV. SM and SV are in equilibrium and coexisted along the curve BC. Then degree of freedom F is equal to C minus P plus 2. Component SM and SV having a one chemical component, that is sulfur, hence the chemical component is 1. Value of C is 1. Phases along the BC which are in equilibrium, that are 2, that is SM and SV, hence the value of P is 2 plus 2. This will come 1. F is equal to 1. Hence the degree of freedom is 1, that is the system along the curve BC is monovariant. Then curve CD. Curve CD is called vapor pressure curve of SL. Name of the curve. Vapor pressure curve of sulfur liquid. Along this curve, effect of pressure at the different temperature is studied. Along the curve CD, there are two phases which are in equilibrium. That two phases are sulfur liquid and sulfur vapor. Means SL and SV are in equilibrium. Then degree of freedom. Next point, name vapor pressure curve of SL. Then equilibrium, SL and SV are in equilibrium. Then degree of freedom. F is equal to C minus P plus 2. Components of SL and SV is 1, that is sulfur, and hence the component is 1. Phases are 2 plus 2 is equal to 1, and hence the system is monovariant along the curve CD. One atmospheric line of the pressure meets the temperature 444.6 degree Celsius. That is the boiling point of sulfur. That is the special point regarding the curvaceity, which we have taken under consideration. Then we have to see the next curve, curve BE. The name of the curve being transition curve. Why it is called a transition curve? Because along the curve BE, there is a transition between SR and SM. At 95.6 degree Celsius, means sulfur rhombic and sulfur monoclinic, they show the transition along the curve BE. Then we have to see the equilibrium. We have given the name of the curve, then equilibrium. Along the curve BE, there are two phases which are in equilibrium, that are SR and SM. SR and SM are in equilibrium along the curve BE. Then the degree of freedom, F is equal to C minus P plus 2. Component SR and SM having the one chemical component, that is sulfur, and hence the component is 1. Phases along the curve BE are two phases, hence write down 2 plus 2. By cancelling these terms, F is equal to 1. And hence the system is monovariant along the curve BE. Regarding the special point of the curve BE is slopes away or shifted away from the pressure axis. As the conversion of SR to SM taken place, the transition point, that is 95.6, at this temperature, SR is converted into the SM. This is a transition point. As the pressure increases, the transition temperature is also changing or increasing. And due to that reason, this curve BE slopes away from the pressure axis. Then the next curve, curve CE, this one. This curve is named as fusion curve. Fusion curve of SR. Means what happens? SR showing the equilibrium between the SM, and SM is showing equilibrium in this way between the SM. SR converted into the SM at 95.6 degree Celsius, and SM converted into the SL at 120 degree Celsius. Means a conversion of sulfur monoclinic into the liquid sulfur is going on along the curve CE. Means curves along the curve CE, we have to see the effect of pressure on the fusion temperature of the sulfur. Means along the curve CE, there are two phases which are in equilibrium, that are SM, sulfur monoclinic, and sulfur liquid, are showing the equilibrium along this curve SR, SM, sulfur monoclinic, and sulfur liquid are showing the equilibrium along this curve CE. The degree of freedom, F is equal to same, C minus P plus 2 is equal to component is 1, phases are 2 plus 2, is equal to 1. Means the system is a monovariant along the curve CE. Degree of freedom I have given here. Special point, curve CE is also slightly shifted towards the right or away from the pressure axis. And why it is so? As the pressure increases, the fusion temperature is also showing changes or increases. Then we have to see the next curve EG. That is the sixth curve. Curve EG. We have to see the curve EG. Curve EG is showing the equilibrium between SR and SL. Curve EG. In this case, SR is converted into the SL. SR converted into the SL. Means conversion of solid into the liquid, that is also called a fusion curve. Conversion of solid into the liquid is called a fusion or the melting. This conversion of SR into SL is going on along the curve EG. And along the curve EG, effect of pressure at different temperatures is studied. Along the curve EG, which two phases are in equilibrium? Along the curve EG, two phases are in equilibrium, that are SR from this side and SL from this side. SR and SL are in equilibrium along the curve EG. Then we have to see the degree of freedom. F is equal to C minus P plus 2. Component of SR and SL is 1, and hence the value of C is 1. Phases are 2, SR and SL, these are the two phases, hence 2 plus 2. Plus 2 minus 2 will be cancelled and 1 is remaining. And hence the system is monovariant. Means along the curve EG, the system is monovariant. In this way, we have explained all the six curves, curve AB, curve BC, curve CD, curve BE, curve CE, and curve EG. In this way, I have explained six curves by taking into consideration the name of the curve, equilibrium between the two phases, degree of freedom along that curves, and in special point regarding that curves.